Hi, I'm Steve Demme, and I've got another idea for a family activity. And this one is walking, or taking a hike, or exploring the great outdoors. This past Sunday was Mother's Day. Mother's Day, special occasion. And when we used to visit my mom, who lived across the state in Pittsburgh, on Mother's Day, we frequently would go for a walk on a wildflower trail with my dad, our family, and we would set up a little grill and have hot dogs, and we would look at the wildflowers and go for a hike of some sort. And that was a really special memory. And this year, Sandy said, you know, I really would like to go to a wildflower trail where we live in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. And so we found one online and contacted the boys, and a bunch of us went with the grandkids. And afterwards, we went to one of our son's house and had a barbecue and sat on his deck and had a wonderful time of visitation. But it started with a hike. And this is becoming more and more common because Sandy and Johnny, who lives with us, and I have started exploring local places to hike. Now, when I was younger and the kids were younger, we used to hike once in a while. Usually it was a Saturday afternoon or a Sunday afternoon, but I wish we had done it more. If I had a do-over, we'd have more hikes, because when we would get outside, the kids just seemed to come to life. Whether they were climbing or running ahead and hiding behind trees and trying to scare us, finding good walking sticks. I noticed two people on this last weekend's hike had their little penknives out, and they had found a dead stick on the trail and they were carving it. And I remember doing the same thing when I was a kid, carving a walking stick and then having a walking stick, you know, just my size, and help me on the trail. And it's just a part of the experience. But there's something so helpful about being outside as families and just walking and enjoying God's creation in the great outdoors. Now, I personally now, I'm older, but I try to go for a 30-minute walk almost every day. I've had a walk this morning, and I use these as opportunities to just be outside, no distractions, and pray and talk to God, listen to God. I like the clouds because the clouds remind me of the cloud of God's presence in the book of Exodus. God appeared in the cloud in the New Testament when he said, "This is my beloved son," and listen to him, talking to his disciples. But then you have the wind. I like when the wind blows because it reminds me of the Holy Spirit coming at Pentecost. And the sun reminds me of Jesus, because in the book of Revelation, we won't even need to have a big ball of fire in the sky or a moon at night. We'll have Jesus, and he'll be the light of the city. So I like creation. I like the birds. I like the wind. And I've got lots of warm clothes, and I try to keep, I even walk in the rain sometimes just because I like being outside. I did a little bit of a study on the benefits of walking, and you probably know all these, but you burn calories, strengthen your heart, lower blood sugar, boost your energy, improve your mood, creative thinking. All these things are benefits of walking. But of course, our purpose in this series is ways and things that we can do to help us as families to encourage each other and to grow closer to each other. And establishing the habit of having a nice walk, perhaps after a meal, is a special experience, and one that we're doing more and more of now. Thank you, Father, for meeting us as we walk. And we can have our prayer walks and our walks that we can connect with you and observe your creation. And it's another way that perhaps it'll draw our family close together, something that we can do together. Bless us in that end, in Jesus' name, amen.